Many years ago, I worked with an actress, another fabulous, fabulous woman, who really had the whole thing in perspective. It was 1956 when I had to join Equity and become a union member. And my first Equity job was understudying Tallulah Bankhead in yet another version of the Ziegfeld Follies. Oh, she was something fabulous. This brilliant American actress who introduced the word darling into the American lexicon. Oh God, I adored her. She was the epitome of glamour and sophistication. A few months into the tour, we were in her roomette on a train going to the next tryout town, Philadelphia. And oh my God, Billy, 9 o'clock in the morning, she was drinking bourbon. But we started reminiscing about what had happened in the tryout town that we had just left, which I think was Washington. And she told me that all the kids in the chorus thought she was having an affair with our choreographer, who was obviously gay. And she told me, I remember Tallulah had the whole thing in perspective. She said, "Let's face it, Beatrice, there's a touch of the homosexual in all of us." She said, "It's not the cock. And it's not the twat." She said, "It's the eyes, don't you know, and sometimes the smell of lilac." Which I thought was beautiful. And now that I have offended at least a few of you, I had a dear, dear friend, a very famous female impersonator, Charles Pierce. Charles died in May of 99, and at his memorial, which incidentally he scripted himself because he knew that he was dying, he asked me to read his favorite story, which I'd like to tell you now. It's called A Mother's Ingenuity. John invited his mother for dinner. And when she arrived, she couldn't help but notice how handsome John's roommate was. I mean, she'd long been questioning John's sexuality, and over the course of the evening, watching the two men interact, she began to wonder if there wasn't a little something more between John and his roommate than met the eye. And John, reading his mother's thoughts, volunteered, "Look, Mom, I know what you're thinking, but I assure you, Michael and I are just roommates." Well, about a week later, Michael went to John and said, "You know, ever since your mother was here for dinner, I've been unable to find that beautiful silver gravy ladle. You don't suppose she took it, do you?" John said, "Well, I doubt it, but I'll write and ask her, you know, just to be sure." So he sat down and he wrote, "Dear Mom, I'm not saying you did take a gravy ladle from my house, and I'm not saying you did not take a gravy ladle. But the fact remains, one has been missing ever since you were here for dinner. Love, John." And a few days later, he received a letter from his mother, which read, "Dear son, I'm not saying you do sleep with Michael. And I'm not saying you do not sleep with Michael. But the fact remains, if he'd been sleeping in his own bed, he would have found the gravy ladle by now. Love, Mom." Mm-hmm.